What's up? It's Chase from Fishing Evolution, and I'm going to be doing a What's in My Tackle Box video, and Marco just is about to upload his. It probably has like 9 more minutes.
10 minutes, guys.
Go like it, please. That'll help us a lot, and I hope you like this video. Now, I'm going to be working with the left compartment right now. We have some grippers right here. They're Cuero. Go get some. They're really helpful. And the right one, I have a bobber and then some lead weights that basically I got at Walden Pond, and they're all crusty, so there's no point showing them. Then I have this weighing scale. It's like I've had this since I started fishing. For about a year or two, and have these. I call them hooks on a noose. I have no idea what the hell they are, but whatever. Then we also have these tubes, and they're from Z-Man. Go buy some if you want to. If you're micro fisher, go buy some. And yeah, we have some Havoc Craw Fatty Juniors. I didn't even know that name, honestly. It sounds pretty weird. But this bait, I've caught a couple fish on that. Not too many. I have some size 6 hooks. You mosquito circle hooks. Size 6. Use those for micro fishing, all that. Gary Yamato Senko. This is what I caught some of my big bass on. Then some bobbers, some more bobbers. Some bobbers. Then some more mosquito hooks. There's size 3 to 12 in this little box. There's many of them also. Then I have some power bait. These are both garlic scented. One is pink. One is yellow. This is pink. And then you use these for trout. Some people use them for salmon. And you can use them for bunch. I also have these bullet weights. And this is like from Eagle Claw, which is also what these things are from. Go buy some stuff for them. I recommend it. These weights help me a lot when I need to drop down. And then I also have these pliers. They're in a case. You guys can go buy them. They're really good pliers. Marco has a mini pair of them, and that he showed in his other video. And he's gonna show you guys now. But it has a lock, and it's like kind of like needle pliers. And here comes his, just a mini version,
a little version of mine of his.
Yeah,
pretty cool.
Yeah, and they have basically cutters for your line in the back, which that means I don't need nail clippers anymore. My family's gonna have more nail clippers now because I can't find mine every single day when I try to cut my nails. But go get some. I don't know the exact brand because it's kind of like. I don't know. But here.
Chinese pliers, you know?
Yeah, I guess. Made in China, probably.
Everything's made in China.
Everything. Now we're going to move down to the side compartments. I just have a bunch of dividers in there, which I'm not going to take out or else it's going to ruin it. I catch a bunch of bass on these. Gary Yamamoto Senkos. I recommend this color. It's good for murky water and kind of. Yeah, I use it in clear water sometimes. It depends on if I'm in weeds or not. I recommend them for like weed beds and all that. Now, and this I have nothing. There was that hook on a noose. Noose on a hook. whatever they call them. But now we're going to move to the three tackle box compartments. Marco, I see you behind the couch. But I have this empty one. And we have rubbers and crankbaits. I will show you all the crankbaits. So we got crankbaits, hula poppers, all that fun stuff. And then this, like, really weird bait. I don't know what this was at all. Marco, do you know what this is?
What is it?
It's like, look at that.
Maybe, like, some kind of jerk bait? I don't know.
I don't know either.
That looks weird.
No. So we got some more. The brand is Havoc. They're, I believe, Craw. Oh. Yeah, whatever. I'll find it later. Craw Fatty Juniors, yeah. And then this bait I used to use. I haven't used these types of baits in so long. Marco's messing around with everything back there, but
exploring.
I have not used this in so long, these baits. And then we just have a white fluke. Everybody uses white flukes on jig heads. Some rigged worms. And some grubs, some rooster tails. And that's what's in that box. Now, I tend to, when I go fishing, you can even ask Marco. I tend to come really prepared.
Yes, very
prepared. A bunch of stuff. Now we got some swim baits. It imitates a spotted shad. In the winter, if you move them in a certain way, they kind of look like they imitate a dying shad, which is what the bass are feeding off of in this time, since it's winter. And I have a bunch of spoons, silver and gold, and you can catch a bunch of perch on spoons through ice in the winter. Then I have these. I believe they said Havoc. Like, Havoc. And I think they are swim baits. And they are obviously hooked for you and everything. And bass tend to go for the light blue and orange, as Marco said in his other video. They tend to go for the light blue. I catch a lot of stuff on orange also. Now we also have these swim baits right here. I don't know what these ones are called because I've just had, like, used them. I haven't really used them because I haven't been in the mood to. Oh, wait, I forgot one thing. So I got a homemade spoon that I made with Marco. He's over there uploading his video. And here's a skirted frog. Then we have this skirted frog also. I don't know why I keep saying skirt. It sounds kind of weird, but it has a skirt of colors of green, black, white, and yellow. And basically like your natural frog that like everybody uses. And that's that.
18 subscribers.
We got 18 subscribers right now. And our channel's only been uploaded completely published to YouTube for like 3 hours and not exactly much. Marco, I think you should come over here because I haven't told you this about the scale yet. So this scale is the Dr. Meter electronic hanging scale. Just regularly press the button, weigh, it works very well. And it also has a built-in tape measure.
Wow, that's cool.
I know.
That I did not know.
And it goes up to
3 feet? 4 feet?
40 feet. No, 40 inches.
40 feet.
I think it's almost 4 feet.
Almost 4 feet.
But I recommend this for anybody that is in need of an electronic scale.
A cheap electronic scale.
I bought this for
10 to 15 bucks.
Not that much yet.
Depends where you get it.
Edu Garcia. We hope to get sponsored by them in the future. And yeah, moving on, please. Freshwater carry-on. I'm gonna go through this fast. Lipless crankbait. It's good for spotting where the bass are feeding and everything. And this is like when you're at a new pond. This is basically what you would use, just to locate where the bass are headed. Then we have a rooster tail, some big grubs. We have a lipped cricket crank rattle bait. I don't know what it's called actually.
It's like a jerk adjust bait it, or yeah. Crank bait, I don't know.
It's weird. But you can adjust it by this little nozzle right here with your pliers. You can adjust basically any lipped crank bait with that. Now we also have another Gary Yamamoto Senko right here. Orange and black, a little bit of greenish in there, yeah. We have some spoons. Gold and silver. I like both. One circle hook. Some grubs, beads, and then that's all that's in here. Moving on to my saltwater carry-on. A big, huge swim bait. This is like really big. It's like the size of my hand almost. And then we got a jerk bait. You can also adjust this one by the nozzle with the pliers. Three of these 3-pound like lead weights. More of these oversized grubs, I'd call them. Circle hooks. I recommend these for bass fishing if you want to like hook them in the corner of the mouth. You can, or catfish also. This tends to hook bass in the corner of the mouth more than the lip. I read that recently in this book that I have. And we have some drop shot weights, some spinners, and a leader. And then another lipped jerk bait in there, and I don't want to take it up because everything's coming up. Gibberish today. Gibberish, guys, I'm telling you.
Our first video talking was pretty good.
Yeah.
But now I'm kind of a mess.
Now I'm a mess.
I'm 30.
So, in the future, we hope to get sponsored by Abu Garcia. And hope you guys like and subscribe to our channel. Give this video a big thumbs up if you liked it. Also, go and check out Marco's video that he just made. He just posted it. I think it just published.
Almost. I say published. 5 minutes.
It's a work in progress, guys. I'll show you.
Takes so long to publish these things.
So almost published.
So close. Yeah, and we also we use iMovie to edit our videos since we don't have a lot of like editing software.
Eventually, we're gonna be using YouTube
like on
editing.
Computer and like, all kinds of stuff. But so far, iMovie's been working great for us.
So
yeah,
thank
guys.
You. Like and subscribe. We wish to get a sponsor by Abu Garcia eventually, and we'll be posting. We'll be more mobile toward the summer and the spring.
Mm-hmm.
And hope you guys like this video.
Talk to you in the future.